Guys, welcome back. JyeSpace. I'm here with Kristin from Rise High Financial Solutions. Just have a bit of a chat today about what she does and her business. Where they're down on 279 Churchill Road, Prospect. I'll pass it on to Kristin. Let her tell her story. So tell us a bit about you, Kristin.
I guess firstly, I'm a mum. So I've got two boys who are 7 and 3. I am a coffee lover and a beach lover as well. Find me down by the beach with coffee in my hand with my two boys.
Perfect.
It's kind of my natural environment.
Perfect.
And I'm also a mortgage broker. Mm-hmm. So that's ultimately what our business is.
Cool. So tell us a little bit more about the business and what it does and, you know, what's involved.
Yeah. So technically, I guess the definition of a mortgage broker is to help you find the best possible loan mm-hmm. for your particular circumstances. Mm-hmm. So whether or not that's a mortgage or we do commercial loans or car loans, personal loans, that type of thing as well.
Perfect.
So I guess that's the technical definition, mm-hmm. but I find myself much more as a educator.
Okay.
So I spend a lot more of my time educating clients on how to meet their goals, okay. whether it's to buy their first property to live in or their sixth or seventh investment property.
Yep.
I do a fair bit with clients looking to use their superannuation to buy property as well.
Awesome.
Which is quite a niche market mm-hmm. and quite mm-hmm. in depth as well. So mm-hmm. yeah, and just I guess clients coming to me and having a bit of a plan mm-hmm. in their mind what mm-hmm. they want to do.
So you're very interactive and very sort of on the ball with your clients too then. Yeah, that's really cool.
And a lot of education.
It's hard to find that sometimes, so, yeah.
Yeah.
Awesome. So anything financial, guys, come and speak to Kristin. So tell us why you got started, Kristin. What got you into this industry?
So I've got a background in accounting and finance. I've done mm-hmm. a couple of degrees. Mm-hmm. I, out of uni, went straight overseas and work in investment banking in London.
Yep.
And then from there, came back to Adelaide and worked for one of the big four banks. I won't say mm-hmm. which one.
Yep.
Did that for a while, but I felt like I was in commercial banking, so lending money to businesses.
Yes.
And I felt like a lot of my job was saying no to clients or trying to change their goals to fit within bank policy.
Okay, yes.
And that was really hard. Like, I really mm-hmm. like helping mm-hmm. people mm-hmm. and finding mm-hmm. a solution. Mm-hmm. And every now and then you just have to say, no, sorry, this bank can't help you. And they walk away. So I guess mortgage broking is firstly a way to really help people.
Mm-hmm.
And I deal with
options.
I deal with 45 different banks. If I can't find you a solution right now, mm-hmm. I can help you work on a goal, a plan, a budget to get to whatever you need to
mm-hmm.
be.
Mm-hmm.
So that's pretty exciting and really rewarding compared to just being a slave to the bank.
Mm-hmm.
And at
mm-hmm.
the end of the day, in the bank, you're working for the shareholders, you're mm-hmm. making money mm-hmm. for the bank. Mm-hmm. Whereas now I'm totally working for my clients.
Perfect.
100%.
Love it.
That's
love
really
it.
Rewarding.
Cool. Yeah. Any sort of hurdles, roadblocks, you know, as far as mortgage broking and financial?
This industry is mm-hmm. quite a tricky one. So,
yes.
I mean, I guess getting started, there was the roadblock of having belief in myself to mm-hmm. go from a very secure full-time PAYG position to being self-employed.
Mm-hmm.
And then I guess the next one for me was believing myself enough to take on an assistant and staff. So knowing that I had enough work coming through to be able to regularly pay their income as well. So that was a really big roadblock to take the leap. Both times I'm so glad that I did it.
Yes, it's all paid off.
Totally.
Yeah.
And I think the other one is just the industry is really challenging. We've had in the last 12 months alone, like the Royal Commission into Banking, which mm-hmm, really mm-hmm. slammed mortgage brokers, which is, I mean, there are people in every industry that don't do the right thing,
mm-hmm.
But it was a rather challenging 12 months mm-hmm. to get through that, and just being happy to adapt to changes and
mm-hmm.
I guess getting involved a little bit in government legislation and things like that, which is not something, you know, politics is not something I'm that keen on,
but
when you're fighting for your business and your livelihood, you kind of have to step up a little bit.
Awesome. All right. Your favourite thing about being a mortgage broker, working
I think it's just helping people.
Yeah.
And really changing people's lives.
I quite
often have clients come to me that have huge credit card debt and car loans and personal mm-hmm, loans and mm-hmm, now this mm-hmm. Afterpay and Zippay rubbish that everyone's getting caught up in.
Including me, Christmas is coming.
Yeah, it's a tough one.
Yeah.
But it's just, it's truly being able to make a difference in people's lives. And finances are not something that are very glamorous and a lot of people don't want to talk about. Once they're on the right page and they have the right plan in place, and we can potentially save them a lot of money.
Yeah, definitely.
It's just really rewarding. And a lot of my clients over the years have become really good friends as well. So I've helped them buy their first home, and then they've had a baby and needed an upgrade in their car, and then wanted to buy an investment property. So I feel like I've really been on the journey with them, and I've really enjoyed that.
Built some good, strong relationships there. Awesome. I might just come speak to you, Kristin. Christmas is coming up. I need to get some money together. Where are we at? So what's new? What's your like uniqueness? What's unique about you guys compared to other financial, institutions?
So I guess, I mean, everyone says customer service, but we have won a lot of awards.
Yes, you've shown that before, actually.
Customer service. We just won an award, so it's by the Mortgage and Finance Association for Mortgage Broker Company of the Year in Australia, which was pretty cool. So I guess that sets us apart. The education piece that we do, so we offer free seminars for our clients on a huge array of topics. We have a really active social media page where we interview specialists in all parts of finance, whether it's financial planners or insurances or accountants, and keep a lot of information on social media.
You offer a lot more, don't you? Yeah, awesome.
And I guess the other thing is, personally, I mean, to become a mortgage broker, you don't do a huge amount of qualifications, but I've got 2 degrees in accounting and finance, and having actually worked in a bank, I know exactly what they want to see in an application, and won't submit an application until it looks, I'm not going to waste your time. I guess that, and being able to do a lot of the complex type lending, so a lot of the business lending and commercial loans and things like that that are a bit less black and white than just getting a mortgage.
Cool. Yeah. Last couple, so dream, what's the dream, what's your end game here?
I guess it's just to help as many people as you can. Possible.
Yeah, cool.
I really, really love what I do. And you know, being self-employed, it's often long and weird hours. I do a lot of after-hours appointments with my clients things like that. So you really need to love what you're doing.
Any advice for anyone getting started in this industry or even opening their own business?
I guess believing in yourself is a bit cliche, but it's really important.
It's a big one though.
Having some really good mentors to lean on, and just asking a lot of questions.
I think
that's really important. Find people who are in the industry bodies, do the whole networking thing, which I struggle with a bit, but it's really important in the early days until you get established.
Most definitely. So, 3, 2, 1, let's go. Squats or deadlifts?
Deadlifts.
Running or bike?
Bike.
Pineapple on pizza, yes or no?
Yes.
Yes? Yes. Is a hot dog a sandwich?
Yes.
Why?
Two pieces of bread around a filling.
Okay, perfect, okay. If peanut butter wasn't called peanut butter, what would it be called?
Nut paste.
Toilet paper. Excuse me. Toilet paper over or under?
Don't do over. Cough.
Over, cool, scrunch or fold?
Both,
what set of items could you buy at the cashier to make the cashier feel uncomfortable? I've had some really strange answers on this one.
Pass,
that's cool, yep, okay.
I guess they've seen it all.
Yeah, they've probably seen it all. All right, sit down with anyone famous, past or present. Who would it be and why?
Oh, goodness. Maybe Anthony Kiedis from the Red Hot Chili Peppers.
I really love
his book.
Yeah, his book's got a really cool book.
Such a massive life.
Yep.
Or a couple of my other favourite authors would probably be.
Cool. Yeah, no, he's a really interesting cat, that guy. Yeah. World's attention for 30 seconds. So if you had the world's attention for 30 seconds, what would you tell them, the whole world?
I guess I feel like if people have time to complain and binge on Netflix and spend hours on social media, that really they don't have an excuse not to exercise and set goals and live their life to the fullest. So I think people just lose that perspective sometimes. I think it's good to remember that if you have time to do all those things, you also have time to put in the work.
So you've got time.
Make the life that you want.
That's it. I love it. One more. What makes you happy?
I guess what I started with.
Yeah.
My kids, the
cool.
beach.
And cool.
I love good coffee.
And coffee. Yep. Beautiful. One love. Don't worry. Be happy. Done. All over. Thank you. That was awesome.